Well, I told myself, almost unthinkingly, but like, I knew I was interested in STEM, so I was like, you know, I'll probably just be a scientist one day. Didn't really have to give it much thought. I was like, yeah, that's cool. I'll probably just do research or something. And where's the best place to go in the world for research? And I just figured, yeah, I might as well shoot for MIT. When I did get accepted to MIT, I was in so much shock, and I don't think it really sunk in. It just didn't seem real. Fortunately, MIT is, of course, very, very generous with financial aid. But if that weren't the case, then it could have been, okay, I get into MIT, but then I can't afford it, and I definitely couldn't have without a scholarship. I've been very fortunate to not have to have a job, so I've been able to focus more on my studies and more on other sorts of opportunities on campus. If you wanted one thing that defines my experience at MIT in particular, it is definitely Concourse. It's an absolutely incredible program. I would say that some of the best conversations I've ever had just in my life have taken place in the Concourse Lounge, which is where I spent a lot of my time last year. Concourse has a band now. That's something that's actually new. I got involved with the band, and we've been jamming since summer, and yeah, I've had a few performances since then, a few gigs. It's been really, really good. I'm currently computational neuroscience and philosophy double major. I feel that tackling fundamental problems of the human mind and human nature from both a scientific and a humanities background are equally legitimate, and there's no reason to pen myself into one lens with which to view. I have been trying to discover what it is that I feel I have a genuine emotional connection to, actually digging in deep in the activities that I truly enjoy doing. Sticky AR, that's a project that I'm working on currently. It's spun out of Hack MIT. We wanted to create a platformer game where you have a projector, you have a camera, and a whiteboard that you place sticky notes on the whiteboard or the poster board or whatever it is, and the game will update so that the little character jumping out on the screen will use the sticky notes as platforms. Now, what Sticky AR has sort of become is a project to bring augmented reality teaching tools to the classroom. Because of MIT, I have been able to discover what it is that I really, really love and care about. Someone I can't see. Take my hand, let's see where we wake up tomorrow. Best